Hello, and welcome once again to Music and Taxes Incorporated. Tonight, we are going to have a little discussion about some important information that has been modernized in its description and information overview. And I am so proud to say that in the modernization, people can actually understand it, okay? And please, I'm sorry I said that in many ways, and in many ways I'm very glad, because I have taught for the Internal Revenue Service off and on for over 30 years. I'm a registered accountant with Internal Revenue, and I am a registered teacher with Internal Revenue. And because of that, I have been highly sensitive to the fact that for years and years, people did not understand the information about their taxes when they looked it up in publications, IRS pubs, or IRS explanations. Well, I think those days are vastly being over. So, let's get started with today's world. Independent contractors. Now, for a long time, people did not know what an independent contractor was in the workplace. They did not know the tax benefits. They did not know the deduction benefits. And most of all, they did not know how to register with the Internal Revenue Service to get all of the tax benefits that would be allowed for an independent contractor. Well, those days are fast disappearing, and independent contractors are beginning to be one of the strongest groups of workers in our entire U.S. workforce. So, I highly recommend that you read this. You can find it on your IRS website. It is very simple to pull up and to get the information. It's a number of pages, but they also have resource information listed on the side where you can get additional resource information. Realize that independent contractors are fastly becoming a major part of our workforce going forward. So, the faster you learn about it, the faster you'll be able to take care of the benefits. One of the benefits and necessities of being an independent contractor is having an employer identification number. Now, this is a situation where years ago, in times gone by, an employer identification number was one piece of information filled out, sent to Internal Revenue, and a number sent to them. Well, this is their table of contents now. Talk about times changing. This is 2004. Look at all of the areas that an employer identification number services. And that's just the beginning. So what I'm saying is that as things start to progress, 24, 2025, 2026, and on, you have the opportunity to get the correct IRS information and explanations in terms that you can understand, and go forward with a very successful business life. As time goes on, I will be talking about different types of specialized forms. And you will remember that the employer identification number was important. And for those of you who took the time to read about it, you'll be ahead of the game. Now, the next thing. Who can benefit from all of this in the music and entertainment industry? Well, music and entertainment is huge in 2024 going forward. For instance, we have musicians, sure, and vocalists, sure, and those who design and make the costumes, absolutely, and the video production. But we also have those who build the studios, those who build the stages, those who are making instruments, and those who are in the transportation of musicians from concerts to concerts. And the importance of those in transportation as drivers and as maintenance crews. And that's just for starts. So when you're thinking about the music and entertainment, please start thinking about it in 2024 and forward. Thank you for tuning in. This has been Music and Taxes Incorporated. If you need some tax help, just give me a call. Good night.